So hello and welcome to the Brightside Club on Zoom. We meet twice a month on the first and third Monday at 7 p.m. And today I have our keynote and sponsor, Colonel Donna Foer, and she's fought in two wars. She's a Pentagon survivor, and she keeps going and she keeps us going. Anyone who knows that once you're retired, it's nice to relax, and everybody's been watching the Johnny Depp and Amber case and the Queen Elizabeth's Platinum Jubilee. But people that like Donna continue to be dedicated, and she plans and puts these presentations together for us each month. And we're very, very grateful. And we will talk about topics that that have been going on this month. It's been a very busy TV month for sure. And we will come back to that at the end. But in the meantime, without further ado, I'd like to introduce you to Donna. And she's going to do a series with us on retirement.
Before we get to her, I just want to say, go Donna, go Donna. Go Donna, go Donna. Yeah. Rah, 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 sis boom ba, go Donna.
And right after she finishes, right, we'll do introductions and each of you will get a chance to make your presentations. Right. So okay, over to you, Donna, and we've got some more people coming. So hopefully they'll be here soon. And I will share my slides while you do your introduction.
So Elton and Claire, you know, if you come to this group and you don't smile and laugh and enjoy yourself, it's your own fault, because we have a lot of fun in here and we're serious. I mean, don't get me wrong. We are serious, but you know, if you don't come and fill your cup while you're in here, it's your own fault, because Elton and Claire will fill your cup for you. So thank you for the cheerleading. I needed that. I had kind of a tough weekend. In the midst of other things I was doing that you do on a weekend with all your chores, I actually had to attend two funerals. You know, as a life insurance agent, it comes with the territory. But one of them was a really dear friend. And, you know, you meet people and you get to know them. And when you sell insurance to people, it's not a transactional event where you've bought some shoes and you're never going to see that person again or even remember who they were. When you're selling insurance and you're protecting a family, it's a heavy responsibility. So you develop a relationship with the person and their family. And when I heard that my client had passed away from cancer, it was a heavy feeling. I felt bad because she had been my friend. But the good news was I knew that we had put in plans the protection that was needed to help her family. Because now that she was gone, there would be money left behind for them to carry on and to take care of things that they needed to do without her. So it's always good when you feel like you put the right plans in place and now you get to see the result of that plan that was put in place. But again, it's always difficult when you lose a friend or family member, or, you know, it's just someone who's special in your life. And she was a very special lady. So it was great to see all the family. You know, one nice thing about when you go to a funeral is you get to see all those family members that you may have seen their pictures on the walls, or they may have mentioned their names, and you think, oh, I get to see now the grandkids and the cousins and, you know, all the other family members that she often brought up, but I never got to see them. So there's always this bittersweet to a funeral where you feel bad that your friend is gone, but you get to meet this beautiful family that she's left behind and hopefully be able to help them. So it was kind of an interesting weekend. And then the other person that passed away was someone in my church. And it was very sudden, unfortunately.
Yeah.
Can I say something about that? That was one weekend years ago. And we went to two weddings and a funeral. Two weddings. It was a busy weekend, but I went to two weddings and a funeral. And I tell you this, which was so amusing to us, the funeral was better than wedding.
Yeah.
I mean, it was a blast though, because the people, like the person was just an amazing person.
Yeah.
And you heard the people tell the stories about them. They had fun and we had fun and we laughed, you know, and the weddings, they were, but you know.
And it was a very big wedding.
It was huge. It was a huge wedding.
They had 12 bridesmaids, 12 groomsmen. And yeah, it was just a disaster.
It
they had a wedding planner, and it was just and the funeral was fantastic. So it goes to show
when you think about that and talk about that, that reminded me of that. And so we all want that. I mean, someday we'll all meet our day, but make sure that the people that come have a good time.
But I think what
I agree.
What it brought to us is your life, you know, and your legacy.
Right.
Because some people, even after they're passed on, are so loved and cherished that, you know, people just can't stop talking about them. But I have to stop recording, Donna, because the slides just disappeared. And I'll have to come back with them in a minute. But I'll do that right now. So.